Mr. Pike is watching, as Mr. Toad did call. But in the Thames at Mortlake, another murdered whore. Traveller turns to Godwit as they gaze into the river. The things they find in there can make the poor fish shiver. It's not only justice that has scales, but unlike justice, we're not blind. For Mr. Toad keeps his eyes open and tells Mr. Pike who did the crime.
Follow the river as it bends. Take a stroll along Murder on Thames. The quiet's broken by the barks from the guard dogs of bodyguards. A low paid au pair, she gets a sack from the trophy wife of a plutocrat. See the arms traders and the sally sheiks. A look at paedophile DJ and an Ayn Rand freak. We're vermin privilege and their discreet fees. Lobbying at Westminster's den of thieves. Follow the river as it bends. Take a stroll with me along Murder on Thames.
In the 18th, Robert Cowan was found dead, hanging from the scaffolding beneath Black Prize Bridge. In his pockets were a false passport under the name Jean Roberto Calvini, several heavy bricks, and $15,000 in a variety of currencies. Initially thought to be just another Thames suicide, as the identity and the last movements of Calvi became known, the circumstances of his death became more and more suspect. Nicknamed God's Banker due to his professional relationship with the Catholic Church, his bank also had known links with the Mafia. The day before his body was found, he was removed from his position in the Banco Ambrosiano, and his private secretary committed suicide. By then, he had already fled his Rome apartment for London. Georgi Markov, BBC World Service journalist, walked across Waterloo Bridge to his bus stop on September the 7th. He remembered a feeling of prick or sting to his right thigh, and noted a man carrying an umbrella running away to a nearby taxi. In 4 days' time, he would be dead, killed by a tiny ricin-filled pellet embedded in his skin. In 2001, the torso of a young boy was found in the river not far from Tower Bridge. There was evidence of a ritual killing. Investigations are ongoing and stretch across several countries. Tabloid newspapers are filling in the gaps with words like voodoo and satanist. In 1887 and 88, a series of unsolved crimes took place. Female body parts began to be found in the river, along its banks and in sites close to the Thames. At the time, the deaths were given little press attention, as Whitechapel was the centre of the city's macabre fears and expectations. Torsos floating in the river were just morbid curiosities and footnotes in larger tales of urban horror. In 1896, Amelia Dyer was hung by the neck until dead. No suicide this. Her death was sanctioned by judge and jury for her crimes. Due to the time frame of her murders, she too was considered a possible suspect for the Whitechapel killer. But her victims were less bloody, too young and too many. She killed babies. For a substantial one-off fee and enough clothing for the child, she would nurse and adopt a baby, a practice known as baby farming. In 1879, she was convicted of causing infant deaths through neglect and spent 6 months in hard labour. After that time, the bodies of the children were not given up to the doctors. They simply vanished downstream, or in carpet bags weighed down with bricks. The tiny soul was sinking to the bottom.